This is a Squad podcast.
Here comes the pitch, and it comes in wide.
On the BS3 Sports Show.
Welcome to the BS3 Sports Podcast. We hope your experience with us is amazing. Sports talk, comedy, social issues, and more. BS3 is the best source.
Can you dig it, you son of a...
I've been feeling like I got two parts. Split up in his bed, yeah, it's two parts. Yeah, you twist your wires, reaching too far. But I've been peeping game off the radar. Oh, and I've been, oh, oh my god, then again, oh, feel like I'm dying. And I've been, oh, oh my god, then again, oh, feel like I'm dying. Tell that truth till it hurts you. Ain't nothing changed, though my six, I got inertia, yeah. Shooting up, by the rim. I'm that jump man in my season like a 96. What's that mean? Raw machine, I'm filled up like it's Dose in a cup mixed with Dally. Crip walk, I do lean. Oh my God, with the flex strong. So strong, that's a both flex. Let that bat and bougie like I'm all set. Oh my, what's gotten into that guy? Yeah, you twist your wires, reaching too far. But I've been peeping game off the radar. Oh, and I've been, oh, oh my god, yeah. Then again, oh, feel like I'm dying. And I've been, oh, oh my god, yeah. Then again, oh, feel like I'm dying. Whoa, don't you push me to my limit, no. Put these rapid scars, think I'm playing. This ain't Uno, no. RG Wild Boy, I ain't gon' throw in the towel, boy. But it's staying like an empire, that's distribution and a cosign. I ain't never need to steal, ride and scratch that. I ain't never need to drop a movement. Talking crazy like I'm about to lose it, but I found God in the midst of movement. Yeah, I did. I've been feeling like I got two parts. Split up in his bed, yeah, it's two parts. Yeah, you twist your wires, reaching too far. But I've been peeping game off the radar. Oh, and I've been, oh, oh my god, yeah. Then again, oh, feel like I'm dying. And I've been, oh, oh my god, yeah. Then again, oh, feel like I'm dying.
What's good? You tuned in to the BS3 Sports Show, Sports Talk at its finest. We got a great show planned for today. Going to be talking the weekend sports with my man Tyon Mack. Also talking college football matchups with Larry B. of IE Sports Radio. Talking Major League Baseball playoffs with Jonathan Bates, sports writer for The Inquisitor. Also talking with singer, songwriter, performer, and multi-instrumentalist Ed Roman. Also Terrence Bennett of TENT Sports Podcast. And social media entrepreneur Michael Onofer. So we got a great show. We got my man Tyon Mack on the line as we talk this weekend sports. What's going on?
Oh, hey, how you doing? I didn't hear you.
All right. So, man, we had a very interesting week in sports. A lot of stuff, A lot of different things happen, but we got to talk about the Clemson upset from last night. This college football top 25, AP top 25, is going to be crazy on Monday. Can't wait to see it. But I guess you got to say with Kelly Bryant, I think Kelly Bryant is his name, him going out as a quarterback, I think totally shot that game for them, which is crazy.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, first off, I can't believe that Clemson lost, right? Like, nobody Clemson, can. You know, they've been steamrolling people all season. And you know, and as you've seen, you know, from last year, they took over. They started off from where they left off last year, winning the national championship. And we looked at this team being back in the national championship game again this year. So it was definitely shocking. You seem like Clemson couldn't get off the field, man. Like they couldn't get a stop on defense. And if you look at the numbers, I think they forced one turnover last night against Syracuse. You know, so yeah. You know, that's college football, man. You know, one thing you love about college football is like any given Saturday, or in this situation, Friday, anything can happen. You know, you never know. You always feel like when you have like a top team, that they're always going to be there. You know, they're going to show up for every game. But then when them games against non-ranked opponents for some reason, non-ranked opponents get up for those games. And we saw Syracuse get up for that game. So, got to tip your hat off to him. Also, the coach, Clemson's coach, went in the locker room afterwards and congratulated Syracuse for winning the game. So, that's real big, too. It's a lot of, I respect that they took that loss on the chin and congratulate the other team for the victory.
Yeah, I mean, that's not every coach. Not every coach would do that, where they would go into the other locker room and say, hey, We just didn't play at the top of our game and we lost. So, shouts out to him for doing that, because I don't know if every coach would be that willing to say that. So, yeah, big ups to them. Now, it's going to completely shake up this top 25. They were number two. This has got to be one of the biggest upsets I think I've probably ever seen, where you have a number two team going down. It normally doesn't happen that way, but I think with the quarterback going out, that was a huge deal as to why it went down the way it did. Another upset from last night. Washington State is upset by Cal. I'm from the Bay Area, so to see Cal get an upset like this, I'm almost shocked, because this is something that They're not a top team. Let's all be honest here. They do well here or there, but they're not really considered a top 25. They're not really not considered a top 10. But for them to beat Washington State, who's number 8, is huge, and that's going to completely again upshake and turn over this top 25. I really can't wait to hear and see what this is going to look like, because they were 8th. So that was another huge upset. Excuse me. The quarterback had, I believe he had 5 picks. So Cal defense must be nice.
Yeah, you know what? What's interesting about Cal, man, is Cal has been one of those they've just been one of them teams that you don't know what you're gonna get every week. I mean, this is a team that I saw, I wanna say 3 weeks ago, play against USC. And was playing them point for point until the fourth quarter. You know, so, you know, this is a team that they have talent and they can play, but just something, you know, they haven't took that next step yet. You know, and so to see them get a win against Washington State was real big. I mean, I think, you know, being in California myself and being over here in the Bay Area and seeing Cal, you know, you always seen those instances with Cal where they have a stockpiled talent. They've had a lot of talent on the team. I mean, if you look at the NFL, they've got plenty of players that are in NFL right now that played at Cal. I mean, at one point, they had every running back that came through Cal going to the league. You know, from Javid Best, Marshawn Lynch, I can't think of another running back. There's another running back that's in the league as well.
Kyle Arrington. Then I think he was.
Yeah. Kyle Arrington went to the league. He went to Arizona. I mean, they just had a stable of running backs at one point. So you look at that team, and they've had a lot of talent over the years. It's just for some reason they haven't been able to put it together. So it's definitely great to see them actually get a win like that and hopefully build something. They have a new coach in there who's trying to rebuild this program again. So we'll see. It was a great win. I know Wazoo is they're pretty upset at themselves. Their quarterback was looking at being in that Heisman Trophy race. I think he had like 17 touchdowns and 2 picks on the season. It comes out and throws 5 picks and gets blown out 30. I think it was 31-37-3.
Yeah,
and that's pretty. It's pretty. That's a nice little hit to your Heisman campaign. So. Man, hopefully they bounce back, but really good win. And also, just the strength of the Pac-12, man. The Pac-12 has been trying to show that they can compete with the other teams in the nation. So it's good to see that, too.
Yeah, it is. I think you really get to see what the Pac-12 has and how they match up to other leagues. I think people don't think that highly of the Pac-12. I think they think the only team you have is USC, and they're good here and there. But they've got some runners. They got some pretty good teams in there. So we'll see what happens. But that was 2 huge upsets. Can't wait to see what's going to happen today in today's games, which we'll be talking to Larry B a little bit later on in the show, talking about Texas OU and a couple of the other matchups. But the next thing from this week I wanted to talk to, shout out to Sluggo in the chat room. Once again, everybody that's tuned in, you can join in on the show chat room. It's very interactive. We'll give you a shout out. So shout out to Sluggo in the chat room. Also, Marcus Harper. He does a Marcus Harper show live on 2 Live Stews Radio. So shout out to him. So AP to AZ, did not see this coming at all. I did see him getting traded. I will say that, but I did not see him going to Arizona. And the funny thing about this whole story is Chris Johnson basically comes out and says, yeah, AP needs to get more touches. Yeah, he's about to get more touches on your team with you no longer on the team, which is crazy how that all went down. But I think AP is going to get more than enough touches. This is I've said this a couple of times now. He needs to get 20 to 25, even 30 touches for him, I think, to be effective. And I think he'll get that in Arizona.
Yeah. I mean, I hope he gets in Arizona. Arizona hasn't looked well at the football team on both sides of the field this year. So getting a player like AP, you know, if he got something left in the tank, and I do believe he does have some seasons left in the tank. If this is a team that's going to commit to the run and allow him to run the ball, then this will definitely be a plus for him. This is a guy who can be a north-south runner. He doesn't dance in the backfield. He gets going, and you don't catch AP in the backfield a lot of times for losses, right? So this is definitely a good pickup for them if they can get this offense going in the right direction. So it takes some pressure off of Carson Palmer, who hasn't been great this season. At this point, the only thing that I love about Arizona is Fitzgerald. For some reason, Fitzgerald, who, you know, is a better receiver who does not have great speed, somehow gets open all the time, somehow catches anything that comes his direction. If it touches his fingers, he catches it. I mean, his talent is being so wasted right now in Arizona, man. It's been wasted, man. I mean, I've been a Fitzgerald fan since he came out of Pitt 12 years ago. Has it been about that long?
Yeah, it's been a minute.
You know?
Yeah, probably 12 years.
It's been a minute. So yeah. I've been a fan of his since back then. And again, you know, he's having his talent wasted right now, man. This dude is still amazing on the field. still, bro, some of the